Hello there, Dota fan. By now, you've probably seen all the other episodes that we've done getting ready for Dota Dragon's Blood, and if you haven't, you should probably go check those out. But those were made with a more broad, casual audience in mind. If you're anything like me, a true Dota player, you know that we're anything but casuals. So this episode, my friend, is just for you. I'm gonna tell you why you should get excited for Dota Dragon's Blood. Now, I know what you're thinking. I got 10,000 hours in Dota, nothing makes me feel alive anymore, I'm dead inside. Well, don't worry, my friend. I'm gonna make you feel alive again. Trust me, I'm gonna get you pumped up. And reason number one that you should watch Dota Dragon's Blood is 'cause it's badass. Look, Dragon's Blood isn't some mamby-pamby video game adaptation show made for kids. Most of us started Dota when we were kids. Well, now we're adults. Many of us are still man-children, but still. As such, Dragon's Blood is adult. Characters curse, have sex, get drunk, and get eviscerated violently. Ugh, gloriously. Much like a ranked Dota game, in this world, anything could happen. And typically, the worst does. The show was made with a mature audience in mind, so don't expect any predictable plot lines or forced morality. This is a show made for grown-ups that respects you, the viewer. I mean, you know the world is cruel for no reason, and sometimes bad things happen to good people. You're a Dota player. Happens to you in every pub. Now let's talk about the creators of the show. If you're an animation fan, you're probably gonna watch Dragon's Blood anyway, 'cause, you know, animation fans watch everything. But if you're a Dota player with no history in anime, worry not, we're in pretty good hands. The anime is developed by Studio Mir, which is the studio behind several big-name productions, such as the sequel to Avatar, The Legend of Korra, and the Voltron Legendary Defender series on Netflix. These guys have been doing animation for a very long time and have stayed very faithful to the source material. You're gonna see heroes use the same weapons they use in the games, they're gonna act like, you know, their characters. But more importantly, you get to see spells, weapons, and these characters in a living world. Ever wonder how devastating a lucent beam really is? Well, now you get to see firsthand. Not only that, but the talent for the show is pretty bang up too. It was written by Ashley Miller and his team, who worked on Black Sails, Thor, and X-Men First Class. Not to mention, we got some pretty hype voice talent as well. Troy Baker, Tony Todd, Josh Keaton. I mean, these are real names, folks. Anything is possible in the world of animation. And that's what's so exciting about having animation as a medium. In the Dota games, heroes and spells are constrained by game balance, but in a story-driven animation, we can see the heroes at their full might, unchained by the shackles of Ice Frog to showcase their power as much as they see fit. And it is glorious to see the abilities we have been spamming for a decade showcased on the big screen for the first time. Now, spells and weapons are nice, but it's the heroes themselves that are the big focus. Take, for example, Invoker, who doesn't even have a single greeting or rival line specific to another character in the games. I mean, we have never known anything about Invoker, despite many of you losing your mid lane with him every single day. But in Dragon's Blood, we get to actually learn about Invoker's past. We get to see how incredibly overpowered he is compared to other heroes, and we get to add personality to a friend some of us have been playing for half of our lifetimes. I mean, this goes for all the heroes. Murata is transformed from a hideous creature in desperate need of a model update to a living, breathing human who is actually hilarious. But it's not just things that we know being given love and life, it's expanding our Dota universe itself. The show is rife with new places, new characters, new laws of the universe, and even new enemies. The Dota lore has been scattered at best in the past, but the show seeks to pull it all together, to add cohesion to the universe. Now, this is extremely exciting for lore nerds like me, but it's also fun for normal Dota fans as you get to see tons, and I mean tons, of Easter eggs and background stuff in these episodes. Any Dota fan with a keen eye is gonna have a blast seeing all these little Easter eggs for the first time. And don't worry, oblivious hard carry players, you'll probably like the show too. So let's get down to it. Why should you, Dota fan, watch Dragon's Blood? Well, because it's an experiment. Never before has Dota been shown to a broad audience. Dota is notoriously hard to get into, it is impossible to master, and you know as well as I do that when we try to trick our friends into starting down the path of Dota, their first comment is, "What the hell is Dota?" Now, we finally have a way to ease people into our universe. We finally have a way to show our friends and families Okay, you probably shouldn't watch this show with your parents. Dota in an exciting and easy to digest way. We finally have advertising for our game that we have been supporting and making the greatest multiplayer game of all time. Finally! So yes, it is your moral obligation as a Dota fan to watch Dragon's Blood. It is your duty to share it with your friends. This is our moment to show the world what we have been grinding for in the prime of our lives for years. It is time for the masses to be introduced to Dota. And if that don't get you hyped up as a Dota fan, well, I don't know what will. So get out there, go on your Netflix, and watch Dota Dragon's Blood. Tell your friends about it and introduce them into the Dota world. Go into game as Dragon Knight and type only quotes from the show. Get excited, folks, because this might just be the beginning.